Hello YouTube, Hot Lead Retired here. And I've been thinking about what Trump said about building the wall and have Mexico pay for it. So I was doing a little digging around, and not only is that possible, we're dumb if we don't do it. We're stupid. We can get that wall built for nothing. And let me throw some figures out at you. And I got all these figures that I'm going to state to you, except for the financial one, from the U.S. Department of Transportation. And the website is Trans, T-R-A-N-S, Border, B-O-R-D-E-R, one word, dot B-T-S, dot gov. That's the Bureau of Transportation Statistics. Anyway, transborder.bts.gov. Check it out. And the statistics that I got from that website were how many enter the United States in 2014. It's got every year for like 20 years. How many's entered that from the border from Mexico to the United States? And last year there was 41.2 million that came in on foot. Pedestrians. Passenger car, there was 130 million people came in passenger, private passenger cars. Buses, passenger buses, 208 million came in here. Train. I don't know exactly what you're talking about. I don't know if they run a train down there or not. They probably do. They might be talking about like freight trains coming in here with the people that's on there, the workers and stuff. 108,000 come in here last year on train. Like shipping trucks and semi-trucks and, you know, freight trucks. There was 5.4 million people came in on those. And that is coming in here legally. That's coming in here legal through the checkpoints. Anyway, that totals out to be about 180 million people. So, if you charge them a $5 entry fee to enter the border, or make it 10, 5 or 10 or whatever. But anyway, you charge them $5 to enter in here, you're looking at $910 million. A year in revenue. That's almost $1 billion. You know? And not only that, I was looking at the wire transfers, sent, you know, money transfers like Western Union and a lot of them fly by night transfer people. If you charge them a dollar on the 100, they send out 23 billion U.S. dollars out of this country that cannot be spent in Texas, Arizona, New Mexico, California, all those border states. They send that U.S. money out of here, and that's $23 billion a year those three states don't have, or four, Texas, whatever. And matter of fact, that's $23 billion in U.S. money that's pumping up Mexico's economy because that's extra money to them. That's not Mexico money. That's extra money. But anyway, get back to the point. You tax that $100. You tax for every $100 they send overseas. To Mexico, you throw a dollar on it, a tax. All right. You could generate $230 million a year, and with the entry fee, you know, that's over. That's $1.14 billion a year. Billion. And that's two things that can be done with a stroke of a pen. It won't cost nothing. Or not much, but you know what I mean. And I'm sure there's many other things that we can do to make Mexico pay for that wall. So Donald Trump is 100% right. It is possible to get the wall built and paid for by Mexico. And if we start using these Mexicans that cross the border illegally and put them to building on that wall for nothing except for three meals and a cot down there on the border, work them like we do. We work our convicts here in America. We have them out there picking up trash on the street and stuff. Put them under shotgun and a dog, man. Make them work. Give them one day off a week and three meals a day, and that's what they get paid for. They work, and if they don't work, they don't. Well, you got to feed them. If they don't work, they'll be the first ones out of here. You make them pull a double sentence. If they don't want to work, they pull a 10-year sentence. If they want to work, they pull a 5-year sentence. There you go. Give them something to do. And make it cost that wall even cheaper. So not only is Donald Trump right that it is possible to build a wall and have Mexico pay for it, but we would be stupid not to. Thanks for watching.